Hello, Edge Yoga School. My name is Ashli Campagna of Ashli Campagna Yoga. Welcome to my restorative yoga class. I will say before we start, if you are starting out in yoga brand new, always consult a doctor first before starting a new practice. This particular sequence is great if you're pregnant and you are experiencing dizziness, fatigue, or headaches. So all of these poses are going to help with that issue. What you'll need are two straps, two blocks, two blankets, two bolsters, a chair, and a wall. So things around your house you could use, belts or scarves, books or weights. Everyone usually has blankets. For the bolsters, you could use 2 to 4 pillows, and then a chair and a wall. So let's begin. All right, for our first pose, we're gonna start off in seated mountain, Parvatasana Svastikasana. So come to a seat on a blanket, folded a few times, legs crossed. And just to start, take a deep inhale, close your eyes, draw your shoulders up to your ears, and exhale them down your back. Take a few open mouth exhales to settle into your space. Transition to Ujjayi Pranayama. Take a deep inhale through your nose and exhale through your nose. Finding that slight constriction at the back of your throat so that your breath becomes audible. And once you've settled in, sit up tall. Take a deep inhale and reach your hands overhead. Interlace your fingers and then spin the palms of your hands up to the sky. Start to find length up through your palms as you press your sitting bones down into a blanket. Slide your shoulders into their sockets and breathe for 3 to 5 breaths. This pose is great for second and third trimesters. For first trimesters, I will give you a modification. On your exhale, place your hands at heart center. For my first trimester mothers, place your one hand on your mat, left hand on your mat, reach your other hand up and over, inhale, and then exhale as you hinge down. Try to keep your hip are your sitting bones evenly distributed on your blanket so that you're opening your rib cage on this side. Just a gentle side bend. Inhale, come back up and place your other hand down. Deep inhale as you reach up and over. Exhale as you lower down, keeping your sitting bones even. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale your hands to heart center. This next pose is twisted bound angle pose or Parjva Baddha Konasana. So place the soles of your feet together and knees are wide, you're seated on a bolster. From here, take a deep inhale. As you exhale, twist over to your left side, grabbing your knee. Extend your left arm back to the wall. So using your wall again, remembering to inhale and lengthen your spine up as you exhale and twist. This pose is great for all three trimesters. Again, if you've had any miscarriages at all, you might want to avoid, but this is always, it's always better to do the opened arm or open twists in pregnancy. Gently release to the front and come to the other side. Deep inhale. Exhale, start to grab your right knee with your left hand, extending your right arm back. release back to the front. Our next pose is auspicious pose or Parjva Svastikasana. So cross your ankles, stay seated on your bolster, bringing your chair in front of you with the blanket to cushion your forehead. Take a deep inhale. And as you exhale, gently walk your hands down, rest your forehead on the seat. This pose is great for all three trimesters and just for everyone every day. It feels very nice. Gently walk your hands up and release. Our next pose is supported bridge or Setu Bandha Sarvangasana. For this, you'll need one bolster to lie your back on, that folded blanket rolled up halfway, a couple of blocks to rest your heels on, and two straps. So these straps, one will go on your upper thighs, scooch it up there, and then tighten it just a bit. The other strap will go on your heels, or on your ankles. From here, place your heels on the blocks, gently walk your hands down. You may need to adjust the blocks just in case they're a bit too far away. First trimester pose with your ankles bound together. If you were in your second or third trimester, you would take two stacks of blocks and place your feet about 1 to 1.5 feet apart from each other. Again, to come out of the pose like this, gently walk your feet off the block, slowly roll over onto your left side. I'm rolling onto my right just because there's a chair in my way. Next pose, we are going to be taking legs up the wall pose or Viparita Karani. For this one, the first trimester version, you are going to have two straps high up on your thighs and then one in the middle of your thighs. Pull on the straps to make them taut. Your low back will rest on a bolster, your head and shoulders on a blanket. So come into this pose. Nice and slowly, walk your feet up so that they're resting on your chair and gently lower down onto your blanket. This is the first trimester version. And again, it is a bit of an inversion, so you may only want to hold this pose for a few moments. For the next version of this pose, legs up the wall or Viparita Karani, we're going to come to the wall and put our legs up. So this would be for second and third trimester mommies. So to get into this pose, I like to bring one of my hips all the way towards the wall and then gently lean back and then kind of wiggle and waggle my way. So for this, you'll need a bolster under your low back and a blanket under your shoulders and head. Your arms can go out to the sides, or one hand on your heart, one on your low belly. Close your eyes. You want your bum to be as close to the wall as possible. And this pose is so wonderful for second and especially third trimesters. You're carrying around a lot more weight with the baby and pitching forward. There's so much more weight in your feet. So this gives some really, really much needed relief. Stay here for 3 to 5 minutes. Breathing. Gently to come off of the wall. Slowly walk your feet down towards the left side, always. And slowly make your way back. And for our last pose, of course, corpse pose or shavasana. So you'll need a bolster on the long way on your mat, a blanket folded a few times at the top. From there, turn your back towards the bolster and gently walk your hands back and rest. The blanket you can adjust if you need to, so it's right under your head. And just allow your heart to open here. Bring your awareness to the areas in your body that hold tension. So clenching your jaw, let it go. Release your shoulders. See if you can soften your belly. Unclench your hips. You can stay in this pose for anywhere from 5 to 15 minutes if you wanted to, even longer. Whatever your body is calling for you to do, you can do it. When you're ready to come out, take a deep inhale. Exhale out of your mouth and bring movement back to your fingertips and toes. To your left side, curling into the fetal position, hug your knees up towards your chest, slowly press yourself back up to Sukhasana, easy seat. Place your hands on your knees and allow the movement that you did in class to just wash over you. Take a deep inhale, reach your hands up and over, and exhale them to heart center. Thank you for sharing your inspiring practices with me today. Please go in peace with joy in your heart.